ith factor. So if you generally if you go with ith factor, so for dissociation, I value if you always it will be greater than 1. Okay, so I value if you consider with the dissociation, I'm saying so that I value this value will be greater than 1. In the sense, you will get almost positive values you are going to get. Okay, so if you go with association, this I value remains lesser than 1. So almost you will get with the minus. Okay, so minus value you are going to get with this concept, I factor. Now, if you are going or relating to the colligative property, when we are writing equation, so how we are supposed to write the equation? When you are writing colligative property, you are supposed to add with the ith factor. Okay, you have to add with the ith factor. For example, the first colligative property that goes with the relating lowering of the pressure. So the formula it comes like P naught minus of P by P naught is equal to x2. Right? So this is the relative lowering of pressure. Now if you will go with the elevation in boiling point, so that goes like delta T B boiling point is equal to KV into M. Okay? So now if you will go with the depression in phase and point, delta TF is equal to KF into M. If you go with the fourth one, that is osmotic pressure, pi is equal to. Okay, so that goes with CRT. So this is the main formula that we have seen already. So this is the formula that goes with your colligative property. Now if you are relating with the ith factor, so Van't Hoff suggested that when you are relating these concepts, okay, colligative property with the ith factor, if you want to find out the exact molar mass over here, so you have to add with ith factor. So everywhere you have to add I. Okay, so this is the ith factor that mainly goes with your abnormal molar mass, just to find out the exact accurate mass of your solute which is present in the solvent. Okay, so this is regarding the concept. Okay, so this goes with abnormal molar mass. So under this concept, for state syllabus they won't ask much question. Okay, problems won't be asked. They can ask what is a Van't Hoff factor for colligative property. They can ask. For CVAC, under this problem also they can ask, which is there in the textbook. In this problems are there. So just try to solve. If you are not, easily it is understandable in the sense, you just keep it like that. Then when you come back, I'll explain. Or by next class, I will explain. So this is the end of the chapter, that is solution. So generally in this chapter you have learned regarding two phases, that is solute as well as solvent, which goes with the binary solutions. Okay, and you have learned regarding the concept in the sense types of solution, meaning it goes with the solvent factor, and you have learned the concept of solubility, which mainly it goes with the solid in liquid as well as gaseous in liquid. Mainly it deals with the temperature as well as pressure. Okay, so that factors are very important. And later on you have learned regarding the concept of the gas which is present in liquid, what will happen regarding vapor pressure. Okay, so vapor pressure in liquid, liquid solution also you have learned. Okay, so based on that, some of the problems as well as the last concept, that is colligative property with the formula and abnormal mass with the Van't Hoff factors. Okay, so this is the concept under the chapter of solution. Thank you.